In this lesson, we will find out how high availability clustering is working. So in high availability clustering, we have multiple nodes. Let's call them N1, N2, and N3. The goal of high availability clustering is to provide the availability of vital resources in the cluster. So let's say we have a database server. And this database server is of vital importance for the cluster. So what we are going to do in high availability cluster is as follows. We make sure that the nodes are going to work together to guarantee the availability of the database. In order to do so, we create a cluster. Now this cluster is using multiple layers. In the lower layer, we have the communication between the nodes. We call this the membership layer. On the membership layer, the cluster is going to detect if nodes are still available. Then there is the resource management layer. And the resource management layer is taking care of the availability of resources. Now, if something goes wrong, it can go wrong in two different ways. The first thing that can happen is that a node in a cluster goes down. If that happens, then the cluster membership layer will detect, and if it affects the availability of the resource, it will be able to migrate the resource to any of the remaining nodes in the cluster. That is one vital part of a high availability cluster. And the other important part is resource management. Now, what is resource management about? Well, simple. Imagine that all three nodes in the cluster are still operational, but the resource goes down. Then the resource management layer will know because of monitoring. Monitoring means that the resource management layer checks the availability of the resources, and it will make sure that the resource is restarted somewhere else. In a high availability cluster, the resource will always be running on a specific node. And that means that if something goes wrong, the resource is restarted on another node. And that means that a high availability cluster will increase the availability of your vital resources, but it won't make it perfect. You won't get a situation where resources will be up and running for 100% if you configure just basic failover high availability clustering. This course is mainly about high availability clustering, and in the next lessons in this course we will zoom in much more detail in the workings of a high availability cluster.